underway, and Marshall will take a knee in the end zone. Duck. And Heather Vernon Adams had a terrific debut for Oregon against Eastern Washington, threw for a couple of touchdowns, 246 yards in his first snap, and they'll give it to Freeman, and Royce Freeman gets knocked down a very short game. Adams' first pass is complete. Got it out to Charles Nelson. Nelson, who didn't play last week, had a lower body injury, but that lower body appears to be quick. Pickup of 19. Now back to the ground, and tough go in the middle. Freeman's carried it a couple of times and maybe has 2 yards. This play might be a good one. It had Marcus Mariota's picture on the play card.
I like that.
Adams. Getting rushed, and he just tosses it out of bounds. 3rd and 9 coming for the Ducks. And to the point, Oregon deadly 3rd and short. Not quite as proficient on 3rd and long. Adams, nice grab out of the backfield. And Freeman will have the first down. So Oregon executes very well, and good sticky hands from Royce Freeman. Pac-12 offensive freshman of the year last year. He has it again. He's running through Spartans and driving inside the 40, a pickup of 7 or 8 on first down. We almost had a mishap with the official trying to get out away from the snap to allow the substitutions. It'll be 3rd and short.
Hey, you better get out of the way when Oregon snap it on offense. The official, you better come on now, big fella. Come on. It's going to be a long night.
Another 3rd down opportunity for Vernon Adams. Flags fly, and I want you to notice too, Kirk, as you heard the whistles and the flag, it looks as if there's going to be a false start.
Prior to the snap, false start number 62 on the offense. 5-yard penalty, main 3rd down.
Penalty called on Pearson. So you have Nelson back, you have Allen making his first appearance this year as well. Adams escapes a little trouble, throws it to the outside, and there's Nelson again making a grab. 1st down, Ducks. Adams being chased, gets away from one. Now Adams firing toward the end zone, just out of the outstretched arms of Braylon Addison. Running back is Kenai Benoit. Nelson gets it out in the flat. He's got a couple of blockers. Nelson spins his way down close to the 20-yard line. Another good pickup for Charles Nelson, stopped by Darian Harris. 3 receivers top of the screen. They'll keep it on the ground. Freeman, big hole, burst inside the 10 and down inside the 5. 1st and goal coming for Oregon.
I've been saying it for years. In this offense, you get so caught up in the tempo, and they're throwing it out to the perimeter, to the left, to the right. And then you get lulled to sleep, and they rip up the middle with Freeman.
Michigan State was scrambling to get lined up. Vernon Adams keeps it. Picks up 2, maybe 3. It'll be 2nd and goal. Give Freeman. Finds his way nicely into the end zone, and the Ducks are on the board. Apparently not. Now, Oregon,
here we go.
Oregon does this a lot. They count the numbers.
Wow. Bring them in.
And now, okay. No advantage.
Yeah, I thought Vernon was.
He showed some little tight, didn't he?
Showed some nerves there.
Hey, look, you're talking about a guy who threw for more than 100 touchdowns and 10,000 yards. I know it was at the FCS level. So now, Oregon will kick it off. Matt Wogan, the kickoff specialist for the Ducks. And deep into the end zone and being encouraged to stay put is R.J. Shelton.
Yeah.
Connor Cook, head quarterback for Michigan State. Spartans will keep it on the ground. Madre London racing into Duck territory, running over an Oregon defender. And that's a quick strike way to start, and the Spartans answer by immediately going into the red zone. Chris Cisse saved the touchdown.
You work all week to come up with your favorite plays. Look at this. I mean, Brian Allen, the left guard, had no one to block. That play opened up so well, the left guard had nobody to pick up.
He had 59 yards in the last game against Western Michigan. 62 on that carry. Worked well once. Go back to him, but this time the Ducks stop him for virtually no game. Kristen French with the stop. 7th-ranked running back in the country, according to ESPN. Connor Cook, play fake to the end zone. You know who he's got. Josiah Price, touchdown Spartans.
That's what we call an answer, right? That was pretty quick.
How about the role reversal here? Both teams go 75 yards for a score.
Although Michigan State, team that used to win with defense and special teams and field position last year, became a different team with their ability to score points.
Byron Marshall is chased back into the end zone, and this time he'll bring it out. Marshall looking for a little crease. Now he breaks it back, and he's got room. He's got room and some help on the outside. Marshall just couldn't quite turn the corner to take it to the house, but a terrific return by Byron Marshall.
And that's when you play Oregon, you have to be concerned not just with defending them on defense, but on special teams, because of guys like this. They get their football in the hands. A great block there by the big tight end, Evan Bayless. And then that's just athletic ability and vision. You can remember, he's a former running back, ran for over 1,000 yards 2 years ago, 1,000 yards receiving last year. He knows what to do with the football when it gets into his hands. And that time he found a crease to the backside, almost got to the corner, and took it all the way to the house.
Well, Kirk, he's the only guy in Pac-12 history to finish the season with 1,000 yards rushing, and then the next one with 1,000 receiving. Charles Nelson appears to be on his way, maybe not to 1,000, but on his way to 100 with his catches tonight.
The Michigan State secondary is not getting off of these blocks from these wide receivers. That's why there's so much room to run.
Freeman kicking and pushing his way until Joel Heath knocks him down after a pickup of a couple.
And then the way they can still hit a crease and get vertical in a hurry.
Adams left it, and the ball's on the ground. Freeman put it down, and Oregon was able to jump on it.
You bit it, you win it against the offensive lineman, and you get penetration.
Vernon Adams needs 18. He's going to get nothing and like it. Oregon fans, I would like to introduce you to Ian Wheeler. You haven't seen him this year because this is his first punt of the year. And it was not necessarily a very good one.
After that great introduction.
Yeah. Mark D'Antonio credits for his ability to build such a stable program here as Michigan State has the ball back and spreading it out all over the place. Quick pass out from Connor Cook, R.J. Shelton, and nobody, no room for him to run as Reggie Daniels stops him. Second down and 10. Cook, quick pass out to the aforementioned Burbridge, who makes the grab. Now Connor Cook will try to convert this third down. Cook fires it into a tight window and unable to hang on out there. Joe Walker knocked it away and broke it up, and Michigan State will have to punt. Addison standing at his own 25. Hartbarger hits away a better punt than Wheeler did for Oregon. They're trying to flip the field with a kicking game, and excellent coverage on Addison down there to make the stop is R.J. Shelton. Well, it feels good to have all kinds of football back, huh?
Sure does.
In college last weekend, now the NFL's going full bore too. Back to the ground with Royce Freeman. He's hit right at the line of scrimmage, but he was second in the country in yards after contact last week, and he picked up a couple after getting hit there.
The matchup up front definitely favors Michigan State's defensive line.
Freeman gets out in the flat and empties, and Adams throws it, almost had that thing picked off. R.J. Williamson almost picked that thing off the turf.
So they want to corral him and get a push, really have an impact and affect his vision looking downfield.
Michigan State is rotating defensive lineman. Adams gets away from a sure sack, but he doesn't get away the second time. Didn't that initial escape remind you of the Mariota play last year on third down?
Yeah, turning point of the game.
But the result did not change, and another short punt from Wheeler and a bad bounce for the Ducks as it goes inside the 40. Will Oregon can't punt it. Second straight 25-yard punt. And now back to the ground for Michigan State. And Madre London is greeted in the backfield. He'll lose one or two.
Michigan State needs to capitalize on this opportunity after the punt. The punts from both teams, they're in plus territory. They've got to try to get points.
Cook firing it complete. Burbridge has it. He's inside the 25, and he'll have enough for the first down.
He kind of has an idea of what he wants to do with the football just based on recognizing the coverage. So when he gets back there, he's ready to get the ball out of his hands.
London, big crease up the middle. Madre London rolling inside the 15. First down, Michigan State. London tried to pick his way, but Oregon there to stop him that time. Yeah. But it's been the middle guys who've created some space. Right up the gut is London. He gets inside the 10 before he was hit by Tyree Robinson. Not quite enough for the first down. Michigan State has put Damian Terry in at quarterback. He's a good running threat, but Oregon is ready for it. They sniff it out, and Tyson Coleman knocks down the sophomore dual threat quarterback as Spartans tried to get a little tricky there.
They get a little bit tricky, but this guy right here, Coleman, he sees this in practice all the time. So he gets off of his block, not worried much about the tight end, and then out in space against the athletic Terry is able to make that play. They tried, as you said, every once in a while, Michigan State will try to slip something in and catch you off guard. Oregon doing their own homework in the offseason. Good job of being prepared and a nice job in the open field by Coleman.
Michael Geiger trying to put the Spartans on top. Short field goal up on the way, and it is no good.
And when you're on the road, you need things like this, right? You need to have things go your way. This is something that typically you're not going to see.
Now Vernon Adams goes back to work with a minute and a half, just over that, left to go in the first quarter. To the ground, Royce Freeman picked up a little over two.
This is where you got to get the ball out on the edge again and throw those quick passes to those receivers.
Adams instead taking a shot, getting his man out there, and it's intercepted! Fought away and stripped away by Monte Nicholson. Nicholson with a tremendous individual play to just take the ball away from Charles Nelson.
It says you got to attack the inside coverage, man-to-man from the safeties. Nelson gets behind him, but the ball is underthrown. You can see he's lost at that point. He just happens to turn and just pull the ball away from Charles Nelson because the ball was not thrown in front. Great athletic play by Nicholson, but he caught a break by the football being underthrown.
A terrific play to set up Michigan State. Great field position at the Oregon 30. Now Connor Cook going to strike, fires it into traffic and too high and incomplete. Machado's now in it right tackle for him. Cook gets it out to Shelton quickly. Shelton trying to make some moves, but too many white jerseys. Reggie Daniels was the first one there. Joe Walker helped him out. And here is a big opportunity for a stop for the Oregon defense after that turnover. Third down, Cook getting pressure underneath. McGarrett King slips away from one duck, and King gets down close to the first down. Let's see where they mark him. It's a no decision at all here. D'Antonio's going to go for it on fourth and one. Pushing ahead. Connor Cook on the keeper, and he'll have the first down. Cook owns a victory over Hogan in the Rose Bowl, also a Big Ten championship as the freshman L.J. Scott looks for room. Trying to put Michigan State on top of Oregon. Second down and eight. Cook throwing over the middle. Got his man. First down and touchdown, Aaron Burbridge.
Put it right on the money.
Second touchdown pass of the night for Connor Cook. Oregon has already allowed seven touchdown passes this season. Kickoff is going to go very short. Ball's loose. Somebody better jump on that thing. And the ball is still loose, and Michigan State had an opportunity to grab it. Find that game on the watch out. Vernon Adams right through the hands of Charles Nelson. And
so you're starting to see Michigan State moving around. See the stemming and the moving. Starting to create some confusion up front.
Going to try it again. This time Nelson sure-handed. Nelson's explosive. He is just about first down yardage. Monte Nicholson gave him a shove just as he got close to the marker, and they're going to spot it right on the chains, and they'll move him for a first down. Nelson now coming in motion. Royce Freeman, one man to beat. He slips inside him, and a sure tackle hanging on by Ante Copeland.
And it's just a play or two that can spark it.
Adams pumps. Now flips it out, a little attachment play. Nelson has it again. He steps through a couple of Spartans and gets inside the 45. Another first down for the Ducks. Adams to a wide open Braylon Addison. Addison spins away from a tackler. He's inside the 20, and dragged down finally, but it'll be first and 10 for the Ducks. And just after we send the Ducks an unproductive series, they're right back to moving it, finding the big tight end, Evan Bayless, and Bayless rumbles down. He'll be marked out of bounds just about the 3-yard line. First and goal for the Ducks. And a little size to block. Adams going to keep it on the run, trying to beat a couple of Spartans to the corner. Adams reaching and stretching, and he's going to be stopped just short. Jermaine Edmondson on the tackle. That stretch almost got it in and put it right on the doorstep. I don't think he got a great spot as a result. And now they're calling it a false start penalty.
False start. Offense number 83. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Adams pulls it down. He's got a crease, but oh, a great tackle right at the goal line, and Vernon is stopped.
Bola gets off of the blocker. He had to deal with an offensive lineman, the center, Haggerty, gets off of him and makes the play.
Now Freeman tries to go over the top, and he is denied. It'll be fourth and goal. Vernon Adams wants to go quickly here. You see if tempo can get him in. Freeman. Boy, that was some good penetration. Boy, Freeman in the backfield with Adams. Vernon sending Marshall in motion. The give is to Freeman. Freeman pushing to the goal line. Michigan State thinks they stopped him. And they did. He's driven him to the other end of the field if he had had time. What a play by McDowell. Yeah, they say they can. Michigan State has every tight end on the roster in the game and also a fullback, so it looks like they're going to try to blast it out of there. And you don't want to dance sideways too much down there and give up a couple to Rodney Prevost. Third down, Cook needs 9. He also needs to get rid of it before he gets hit. He found his security blanket, Josiah Price. Now a little breathing room.
I'd be surprised to see him take a shot.
I wondered if they would out of their end zone a moment ago. Short pickup on first down. It's a lot of stake in that game between the Volunteers and the Sooners. Oh, fly sweep to Shelton. Shelton quickly across the 15. He stopped at the 18. It'll bring up third down. He'll need about 5. Cook standing in there. That was a bit of a dangerous throw. McGarrett Kings made the grab and he stretched the ball out. Terrific play by Tyree Robinson will stop the Spartans short. Michigan State will have to punt it. And Jake Hartbarger, his first punt was a beauty. It went 57 yards. And also pinned Oregon deep. Braylon Addison is standing at his 30. Hartbarger unleashes another beauty that drives Addison back to the 25. Picked up a block, no flag came, now it does. Late flag for a block in the back on the initial helper for Braylon Addison. He got the return across the 42.
During the return, illegal block on the back, number 26 in the return team. 10-yard penalty, first down.
Reggie Bush, Matt Liner.
And then you get into that issue, and I would think the next logical guess would be Notre Dame in the early days as Vernon Adams. Firing for Dwayne Stanford, and it's incomplete. Wanted to play on the big stage. Followed Marcus Mariota. Short completion on second down. Had to pass a math class that put him into camp. Adams ducks under one pursuer and then gets rid of it at the end, and he has a man open. It's Addison. How about Vernon Adams? He threw the ball with his
left hand. He threw that left-handed.
That was not a shovel pass like we saw Mariota do last year to Michigan State. This is a left-handed throw. I'm just going to throw it left-handed. I'm just going to work. I'm going to work with my right to keep you off, man. I'm just going to throw it out there with my left hand.
Of all the accolades I just gave Vernon Adams, who knew he was ambidextrous also?
Right.
Now Adams uses his right arm and tries to put in the seam, and he's picked off for the second time tonight. R.J. Williamson.
We'd be able to break down.
We'd had to count back. That's kind of what we were doing. Yale and Army are the two as Connor Cook's pass is complete the verbiage.
This is part of the growth of Vernon Adams, again, a staple in this offense, something we've seen a lot of, you know, where they kind of pump fake right here to get the defense to come up, and instead of going here, they actually go there to try to get it thrown to the outside, and he ends up stepping up and just throwing it, not seeing the safety who just watched him the entire time.
Cook pulled it out of L.J. Scott's belly and then rifled a dart right into Burbage's midsection. Spartans with a 14-7 lead, an opportunity to stretch that advantage here late in the first half. Back to the ground, patiently running and getting the first down is L.J. Scott.
So you better be using your hands legally. It's completely legal.
He's a devastating blocker. That time he takes on the block up high, and L.J. Scott runs through a defender. And
this was going to be a litmus test to find out really how far they've come up front.
Cook on the move. Fires it into a tight window to McGarrett Kings, and there's a flag coming in as Cisse was working on Kings.
Cisse got a lot of time last year.
Pass interference. Defense number 12. Ball replaced for spot of the foul. All out of first down.
And gave up 438 yards passing to Eastern Washington. Connor Cook going to try to get a big chunk here, but he threw it into traffic, and he is very fortunate, is Cook, that Reggie Daniels didn't come away with an interception. Second down and 10 after the near miss for Michigan State. Cook, this time it is intercepted. He tempted fade a couple of times. That might have been a miscommunication, and it's picked off by Ugo Amadi. And Ugo Amadi, the freshman from Nashville, Tennessee, was sitting there waiting, and he hauls in the interception. So the first turnover of the night for Michigan State.
Receivers out here, he's gonna work to the inside, and this is where the corner sits, and he's just gonna drop back in coverage with his eyes on the quarterback, and it looked like Kings goes down to the inside, and he might have when he was breaking down his route, you know, if you're a yard or two short or a little bit longer, you're not on the same page with the quarterback. And these are guys that have played together for 3 or 4 years. You would think that would not happen. Here's the eyes of Connor Cook reading and looking into that defense. One thing that he really has worked on this year is not being greedy.
And Adams has some time maybe to pull this thing even before halftime. Tunnel screen. Here's Byron Marshall. I haven't heard much from him tonight, and he doesn't get much. Oregon with all three timeouts to work with. Vernon Adams. He checks it down. Freeman's got the edge. Freeman knocks off one man inside the 35, gets out of bounds and stops the clock. First down for the Duck. Adams dancing around, and he danced too long. Knocked down and sacked. Lawrence Thomas was the first guy there. Got some help from Craig Evans. They're taking a lot of time for a team that loves to go quick. Adams pump fakes, and down he goes again. Now they have 36 seconds to get something on the board.
Soft coverage on the inside receivers.
Adams bails out of there, throws it to the outside, incomplete, fourth and 11. Fortunately for us and all of you, we've got a whole second half of this coming. Vernon Adams on fourth and 11, gonna take a shot. Got a man out there, and Byron Marshall was very well covered on the outside by Deontay Copeland, and Michigan State comes up with another fourth down stop.
Last year?
Again, I caught.
They're not
gonna let me come around anymore. It was the Arizona game that they lost to.
I'm getting out of the booth. I'm out of here. And got the ball out to Nelson. I think that's where their offense was probably the most in rhythm.
Underway in the second half, and the Spartans will start on the 25. First snap of the second half, Spartans will go to the ground, and the first snap of the second half, not nearly as successful for Madre London as the first snap of the first when he went 62. No gain on the last carry, so Connor Cook looking at second and 10. He fires it, looking for Josiah Price, and some really tight coverage from Arian Springs makes it third and 10. Shelton in motion now. Spartans need 10. A little stun up front. Michigan State picks it up well. Cook found a receiver, but not enough for the first down as McGarrett Kings made the grab, and Joe Walker knocked him down about a yard short. And Cook was under 50% completion percentage in the opener against Western Michigan. He's been better tonight, 12 of 17. Another good punt from Hartbarger. Braylon Addison looking for the edge. Addison's got some room, and he's got a blocker. Addison turning on the Jets inside the 30. High-stepping Addison into the end zone. Touchdown, Ducks. 81 yards on the punt return.
He makes the first guy at nine, Monte Nicholson, right there. Little move, and then the blocks that set it up. They set the wall up, and when you give the Oregon speed a chance to work in the open field, and then great effort right there by the outside linebacker, Prevo, to pick up a block.
The Ducks have made this their calling card, their 33rd non-offensive touchdown since 2010. Nobody has had more. Extra point on the way. It is true, and
it is great to see Braylon Addison back playing for the Ducks after missing, as you said, the entire year last year.
RJ Shelton takes a knee. We've got a brand new game all locked up at 14 after that punt return, and Oregon has done a terrific job against the Michigan State running game. Just pure effort from LJ Scott made it a positive game, but only a yard or two. Sam Bradford, who can stay healthy, certainly has the skills out to the outside. And this time it is not Price, but another tight end, Paul Lane, who makes the grab from Connor Cook. Connor Cook
on third down. They're only one of six.
Cook fires the slant, and this time he'll get the first down. Garrett King. Scott powers his way for four. On second down, Connor Cook goes back to the other side of the field, finds Kings again, another first down for the Spartans. Connor Cook is not a highly recruited guy. He has developed into a terrific leader. Now with good protection and good time, and fires a strike and a good catch. Climbing the ladder is Aaron Burbridge.
Now you can go back to your bread and butter and run the power, run the physicality of that running game after you throw on the ball.
And here they come with a running game. But not much there. Boy, the Ducks not pleased with their overall defensive effort last week, but they've done a great job against the run.
They're basically taking that part away and putting the game in the hands of the Michigan State passing game, see if Cook can deliver.
And Cook delivers to Burbridge again, a short game. Michigan State goes to a huddle. That might give us a chance to get that shot in. Connor Cook, again, well protected, but threw it behind and low Burbridge, so it's going to bring up a fourth down from the 34. Shelton in motion, Cook finds Burbridge, and Burbridge has it inside the 10. First down and first and goal for the Spartans.
A great read, and they slip behind the coverage. A well-designed play and perfectly timed, and Cook's trying to go tempo here to try to be in attack mode inside the 10.
He'll go to the ground. L.J. Scott. Scott looking for the corner. L.J. Scott, touchdown, Michigan State.
Michigan State definitely in attack mode. They regretted how conservative they got last year against Oregon as the game got away from them. This year they vowed not to do the same thing.
Now Oregon, whose last score came on an electrifying punt return, to see if they have anything. The kickoff return from Byron Marshall. Spartans have had trouble covering kicks and punts. Not so this time. Ducks go back to work. Keep it on the ground with Royce Freeman. Nice pickup on first down of four.
Tonight they have only rushed for 50 yards. It puts a lot on the passing game.
Adams wanted to throw it this time, but he is caught, corralled, and knocked down before he gets to the first down marker. The first indication tonight that we've seen that is bothering. Kings calls for the fair catch, and he'll make it at about the 22.
Pain for him to let go of that football. He's lucky he landed on it.
Andre London gets the carry in. Spartans go back to the ground. London slips through the initial tackle. Andre London running tough. And up close to the first down mark. Yeah, they have a history of guys who run tough. Le'Veon Bell's one that's here tonight. They've compared L.J. Scott to him. Connor Cook now going to go up top, throwing it to the outside. And Chris Cisse was there on the coverage. There is Le'Veon Bell.
He's become one of the best backs in the NFL. He left this program, and he went to a program in the NFL, but he couldn't have gone to a better fit. I mean, Michigan State and the Pittsburgh Steelers are about as similar as you're going to get.
Mindset, toughness.
Yeah.
Run some power. Run power counter. Slam it up in there, boys. Here we go. On second down and 10. State spreads it out. Cook firing. That was dangerous. Tyson Coleman was jumping in there and got the deflection.
So this is where, remember last time I said he came off? He read the linebacker who dropped into his passing lane. And he threw over here. This time he doesn't see it. Maybe predetermines what he wants to do with the football. He's worried about the corner, but it's the linebacker right here that makes the play on the football. He's lucky that Coleman didn't hold on to that football because he's walking to the end zone.
Grebo trying to turn the corner. Cook steps up, fires a dart on third down, and Michigan State moves the chains.
As he steps up, he works into the pocket. See the edge? The pressure off the edge on both sides by Prebo and French. Steps up, makes a great throw.
Boy, McGarrett Kings has been his guy on third down. Short gain on first down and bring up second and long.
Illegal substitution. 12 men on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
And he'll stay on the ground instead and pick up one or maybe two from London.
So we can't quite give up on being that pounding team.
They run it again, London inside the 40. It's another first down for Michigan State. Well, Michigan State with a 7-point lead, headed down toward the 3.5-minute mark to play here in the third quarter. Reese Davis, Kirk Herbstreit, and Heather Cox with you on a beautiful night in East Lansing. Cook down the middle. He's got his tight end, Jamal Lyles, for the catch, and Michigan State is threatening. Michigan State at the 19-yard line, just in the red zone. Back to the ground, London. Picks up a couple, maybe three. A lot of beef on the right side.
The tackle over on the right.
They run it that way. Tried to cut it back, didn't work. Oregon was ready for it.
Getting a little bit cute there.
So the result of all of that is that Connor Cook has to try to convert a third and 10. Steps up in the pocket, floats it, and deflected, and then almost caught. Tyree Robinson deflected it. Josiah Price almost grabbed it, and it's fourth down.
Yeah, he put a little touch on this, and he's really fortunate. Who do we talk about who he locks in into the red zone? This is his guy. Look at that. Remember, Tyree Robinson is 6'4". Price is his guy.
Now, the last time that Michael Geiger had a field goal attempt, it was not pretty. A 28-yarder he missed. This one from 36. Ball is on the way. And this time it is true, and Michigan State has pushed its lead to double figures.
What about Jake Coker in Alabama? We'll find out if Alabama's for real next week.
The defense can put some heat on you. Short kickoff, rolls around on the ground, and Bayless jumps on it.
He's off on his calculations there completely.
Adams out to Braylon Addison. Complete.
Heather, he's right. I mean, it is the last finger. It's kind of the runner. It's now they're starting to learn a lot more about him.
Freeman carries it across the 30.
Not just, this is the quarterback replacing Marcus Mariota. You need to show that you're a leader in this kind of setting, and that's what they're learning about him.
They desperately need a first down here, and they got it prior to this.
To see if this is an offense that has the ability to be balanced, because right now it doesn't feel that way.
Nelson trying to get the corner. Charles Nelson stays on his feet across the 35. We see the Ducks have lost their last 20 when entering the fourth quarter, trailing by 10 or more. Last time they won, 2004 against Wazoo. If Vernon Adams can rally him. Good start to the fourth quarter for the Ducks as Royce Freeman gets out across the 45.
Boy, it's going to put a lot on Royce Freeman this year in the running game.
Now Adams off play action, down the middle. Braylon Addison makes the grab, and Addison's inside the 35. And
the ball was thrown a little wobbly, but he got it in there.
Oregon move. Looked like the right guard. Came out.
Ball start, 78, offense. 5 yard penalty.
This ball is floating, and it's because of the pressure that he felt right into his face right there. They were closing in on him. The ball just kind of hung up there, but his receiver was so open because the linebackers had sunk in, and Addison easily goes up and makes the play there in front of Cox.
Now, Bucks have to back up five. Addison in motion. Give to Freeman. Nothing doing. Second and long coming. Adams out in the flat, too high for Addison, who wisely chased it just in case they called it a backward pass. On third and long, they flip it out to Freeman in the flat, and he tries to navigate his way through a host of green, and he can't do it. He gets down to the 30. That's about 7 yards short of what they need for the first down.
That's
here in Eastern Washington. Doesn't need a touchdown, just a first down on this one. Adams firing out for Addison, and it is a strike incomplete and a first down. A terrific throw from Vernon Adams.
By Adams on fourth down. He gets it right over the corner that time. Hicks and in front of the safety. What a throw.
Freeman noses down to the two. Well, how big does that look about now? Adams going to keep it himself. Vernon Adams into the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon. The fourth down strike to keep the drive alive to Byron Marshall. Putting it beautifully between a couple of Spartan defenders and then running it in. They're finding out he's got some guts.
I mean, right in front of them. They're learning about, hey man, what do you think about three? What do you think about Vernon? Like right now, they're down there saying they're impressed. They're learning a lot about this guy. After the way that game went last year in Oxford, it's going to be a fun one to watch.
Well, the Rebels have found some offense in the early going. LJ Scott returning the kickoff. Scott still on his feet, shedding tacklers and getting up to the 35. Let's have a look at the last touchdown.
Yeah, this is the big fourth down. It's a long throw from the right hash all the way to the sideline, and he puts it right on the money to convert on fourth down and then follows it up by following, like I said, the left guard Matt Pearson and his tailback Royce Freeman into the end zone. And again, showed some toughness and grit there on that drive.
With jet sweep, R.J. Shelton. Shelton turning the corner. He's got tremendous speed. Dances out of bounds, gets in Oregon territory. On the ground, L.J. Scott. Gets close to first down yardage.
Dude, that 22-year-old freshman's had some moments in his first couple of games.
No doubt.
BYU. Mark Scott just short of the first down on the last carry. He gets it this time and runs through another one. Scott inside the 20. Scott on his way. Will he get there? Touchdown, Michigan State. And just like that, Michigan State is back on top by 10. And now the lead is 10 again. 10:51 to play. And now it's Oregon's turn. Fumble on the kickoff. Marshall picks it up. Tries to find a little running room and is able to make a little bit of chicken salad. Now Vernon Adams has it back at his own 17-yard line. They give it on the inside. And there's some running room for Royce Freeman, and Freeman picks up close to 10. Under his own power, Tony Brooks James, the speedster, getting his first carry of the night.
Definitely speed to complement what you see from the more powerful Freeman.
Back to the ground, Brooks James able to elude people with that speed and gets enough yardage for the first down, it appears. So good running by the youngster. So the first down after the run from Brooks James. Vernon Adams escapes the reach of Shalit Calhoun. Adams going to keep it himself and picks up as much as he can before getting out of bounds. Two-time All-Big Ten performer. You know, he desperately wants to get back in this game. Kenai Benwaz, running back, he's blocking, and Nelson got a little bit tangled up. The coverage with Darian Harris, and pass is incomplete. Third and two coming.
Try to take a shot here on second and two. Confidence that they can pick up the first down on third and two. Anderson looked like he was grabbed pretty good by Darian Harris, but a no call.
Benoit hit immediately and stopped short of the first down. A fourth down is coming. Helfrich never wavered, leaving his offense on the field. Inside 9 minutes to play. Fourth down and down 10. Adams. Oh, beautifully set up screen. If Bayless can get to the sticks, Fry closed quickly. And boy, he had just enough to get the first down. But again, an aggressive play from Fry and a good play by Bayless to get to the first down marker.
Yeah, good effort to try to extend and get this. But I love the call here. You got a tight end and it's in blocking. And you just wait to the last second. The experience of Bayless there, you wait to the last second and then you just dump it off. Touch pass to get over their heads and Lawrence.
Brooks James has it. Looking for room, slipping tackles, and a terrific pickup inside the 45. Maybe 7-8 yards. Let's give him 8 on the first down run. The lead back for the Ducks, and we've seen more from Brooks James. And this is the first time tonight we've mentioned that Vernon Adams isn't the tallest guy in the world. And that time he gets one swatted back at him by Lawrence Thomas.
Yeah, Thomas knocked that down. And
third and a really long one. Adams going to throw for it, going to take the shot. Had a man out there and couldn't hook up with Nelson. It'll be fourth down. And Adams keeps it. Adams stretching it. He stretched the ball across the yellow line, but the official is running in short of where that line was. We'll see where they put it down and how they mark it.
Well, it looked like he extended and got it. Good job by the right guard, Cameron Hunt, who came around, picked that linebacker, Cooper, or Bulla, up right there. And then he looks like, again, by our, they're gonna actually review the spot. But Hunt climbs up to the second level. And our line's usually pretty reliable.
Well, let's see what the chains say. The nose of that football on the yellow line. Kirk has always called it precise. Unerring. But it's a few links short. Now Michigan State is celebrating. And Michael Batlin, the referee in the Pac-12.
Even tonight.
And not having Royce Freeman there to try to pick up that short yardage certainly hurt as well. And LJ Scott is starting to feel his oats here for Michigan State. And Scott averaging 7.5 yards per carry tonight. Madre London's averaging nearly 7. It was London who had the big 62 yarder. Scott this time stopped in his tracks. It'll bring up third down, and the Duck defense needs to get off the field and get the ball back to the O. On third down, Connor Cook throws incomplete. Clock stops. Michigan State in two games has allowed 2 long kickoff returns and a long punt return. See how the Spartan coverage team does this time. Addison wants to go over his head and it'll come out to the 20s. And Royce Freeman is back in now for the Ducks at running back. Nelson in motion. Adams buying a little time, firing complete. It's Addison. Addison headed to Michigan State territory, and he's knocked down right at the 50-yard line. Adams, a lot of time. Thought about taking a shot, pulls it down, gets what he can, gets about 5, and there's a flag that flew deep in the secondary.
Holding. Defense against an eligible receiver.
Yeah, that's
10 yards from the previous
spot. I wasn't saying, I guess, pass interference, but I guess your secondary.
First time tonight a penalty has gone against the Spartans. Ducks perhaps thinking about time. Adams fires to Nelson, who took a shot. Demetrius Cox laying the lumber.
Anticipated it and lowered the boom.
Adams getting heat, dances away from it, now throwing, complete, slipping a tackle is Addison. Addison knocked down inside the 15-yard line, yet another big play from Braylon Addison.
This is almost backyard football. The play breaks down, he just scrambling out to his right, trying to find an open man.
Back to the ground, Freeman spinning, stopped at the 11. This is the type of patience Helfrich can live with. 5 minutes. Tunnel for Addison, shaking guy. Addison pushed out of bounds by Demetrius Cox, and the Ducks are threatening.
Here by R.J. Williamson coming up and trying to make the play. Instead of sitting back, he comes to the ball. And by coming to the football, it gave him an angle to come back to the outside.
7 catches, a buck 39 for Addison. Now back to the ground with Adams. He's trying to find his way, and he is twisted into a pretzel and loses a couple. Adams making checks, and then the flags fly.
They
give him a false start.
Looked like Michigan State moved as well. Both.
False start. 72 offense. 5-yard penalty. Same second down.
Adams still has it. Scrambling. And just gets rid of it. Throws it into the second row, and there's another flag down.
So you could go either way. Michigan State had hands up into the face.
Personal foul, hands to the face, number 4 on the defense. Half the distance to the goal, automatic first down.
He's could have called holding on this guy that he's going up against.
Yeah.
Right in the bottom there.
Yeah.
There's a hold, there's a hand in the face.
And
which way do you want to go?
Both guys had hands to the face.
Right.
So now on first and goal, headed to the corner, to the end zone, Royce Freeman, touchdown. And there's another flag that's maybe coming back for a hold.
Holding call, left tackle.
64 offense, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Yeah, I think he still had it right here on the edge. Just locks up with Cooper. And if he doesn't do that, there is no way Cooper, as a defensive lineman, is going to be able to seal the edge.
So now it'll be first and goal from the 15 after the 10-yard holding walk-off. Adams, good protection.
You better run here.
Yeah. Buying a little time. Still looking. Now firing it into traffic. That is not smart. And it pinballed around for a while before it finally hit the ground. Riley Bullitt was the first guy.
That time, interesting call by Michigan State spying Adams. Nowhere for him to go.
And Nelson thought he had a shot at the deflection. Another opportunity. Adams steps up, avoids one-on-one coverage in the back, and it's Marshall for the touchdown. This is not terribly important at this moment, but that is a new NCAA record, 70 consecutive games with a touchdown pass for the Ducks.
Watch this, but both guys kind of pushing back and forth. Good no call. Marshall goes up and makes the play. Puts it up in the air. I'll tell you, one of the toughest things when you're a young quarterback in a new system, he's played some football but in a different school, is the red zone. This red zone usually is attacking for Oregon. Right now it's almost like they're just trying to feel what might work, and they just kind of threw that up and hoped that Marshall would make a play on it, and he did.
And they do kick it away. Shelton's going to bring it out. R.J. Shelton knocked down to about the 23-yard line, and this on the ground with London, and London is knocked down in the backfield. Christian Frentz and Joe Walker was back there.
And if you're Michigan State, you're working that play clock as much as you can.
Cook is going to try to take care of it, you would think, but whizzed it out of bounds looking for King. So now it's 3rd and 15, and Oregon didn't have to use a timeout.
That's right.
Instead, they're going to let Cook throw it. He went down the middle. He overshot Burbridge, and Oregon, that's as good a scenario as they could have ever hoped for. There's 2:27 left. They didn't burn a single timeout. I think they'll trust him if he can lead them to a score here. Hartbarger gets the punt away, and Michigan State better cover this punt carefully because Addison's been dynamite tonight. Braylon Addison, Addison to the 50s into Michigan State territory, and the Ducks have terrific field position. Nelson in motion. Ducks have time to keep it on the ground. They've got Royce Freeman inside the 40-yard line in Oregon. With a big pickup on their first play and picking up a first down. Freeman trying the middle. picks up about three. ...90 seconds left in the game. Adams taking a shot. Marshall's out there. He was by himself. And if Adams could have put it on him, the Ducks would have had the lead.
This is Michigan State's defense. There's no safeties behind him. He stumbles, loses balance. Look at that. He's all alone. Byron Marshall.
Third down and seven. Spartans bringing pressure from the outside. Adams in trouble. Adams tries to get away, and he does not. A sack. Lawrence Thomas was back there, and Chris Fry finished him off. That's Byron Marshall down there. Those two hooked up to convert a big fourth down earlier in the second half that kept the touchdown drive alive. Fourth and 16. Adams stepping up. Adams firing, short hops it incomplete. Spartans take over.
Illegal substitution, defense. 12 players in formation. 5-yard penalty, first down.
If anything, Oregon's stock goes up, not down.
On the ground with Madre London. And this balanced Michigan State offense has done enough, and London going to put a little exclamation point on it by picking up the first down. Not perform in terms of wins and losses as well as they would have hoped. But a little bit of a cathartic feeling as the clock strikes zero. Mark D'Antonio, Mark Helfrich meeting at midfield after a terrific and entertaining football game that Michigan State pulls out 31-28.